I'm gonna show you how to install Fallout 3 Game of the Year Edition with Lutris. Lutris is a gaming open gaming platform for Linux where you can organize and launch all of your games, both Linux games, Windows games, PlayStation 2 and other emulators, DOS games. Windows games run with Wine. You can use Wine in Steam, so you can run Steam Windows games. So I'm gonna show you how to install Fallout 3. I made a script that configures Fallout 3, applies a lot of small fixes to prevent it from crashing, running smoother, etc. So I'm gonna, this link is in the description. I'm gonna hit install, open with Lutris, and here it asks you to download the files. So if you don't own the game, just buy it here and then download these three files. The links are here, so when you own the game you can just click here to download the three files. Here's some description of what it does, some INE fixes, Intel support, patches for with 4 gigabyte support, so you can use big texture packs, some FOSE mods, boss, unofficial Fallout 3 patch, and a special launch menu, and a cool background image for the Wine virtual desktop. So let's continue. It will install into my Lutris game directory. It downloads a version of Wine. This will run in 32-bit because the game is 32-bit. So now I'm gonna choose the executable file I downloaded from GOG. So it's in here. So you just choose the first one. The other two will get loaded in by the executable. And continue. And it downloads some files and a mod pack. The mod pack contains FOSE, which stands for Fallout Scripting something. NVAC, which is New Vegas Anti-Crash. It also works in Fallout 3. And Fallout Stutter Remover to get a smooth FPS and to have the voice, the dialogue animation to match up with the sound, so you don't get too fast mouth movements. Do you want to store games in my home directory? Yes, because this way I can use the same save directory in both Steam and GOG and stuff. And now it creates the Wine prefix. Installs Quartz, which is needed for getting the in-game radio to work, the music. And here it extracts the files from the GOG installer, so you don't see the GOG wizard. It just uses an extractor to extract the files, and this will take some minutes. And while we wait for that, you can also use the Steam game from Steam and use the other installer, but you have to switch to the Wine Runner afterwards and enable Virtual Desktop to get FOSE working. But otherwise it's very similar to GOG one. The GOG one has, I think GOG has made some patches to it to disable games for Windows Live. Yes, so it should work more out of the box from GOG than Steam version. Also with Steam version uses Steam, so you will have to use Steam for that. But it's on sale on Steam right now, so it's cheaper on Steam right now. So I haven't tried. I don't own the vanilla Fallout game on Steam, so I haven't tried it. But Yeah. There's only one version on GOG, and it's the Game of the Year edition, and it's the one you want anyways. It has all the DLCs. Yeah. The game is about 9 GB, so it takes a while to extract. Can also view the installer if you want to see what it does. Always do this before installing from Lutris. So create prefix, disable virtual desktop, install quartz, set a wallpaper, you will see that later. Enable grab full screen, faking Nvidia GPU, which is needed for Intel. Disable always off screen. I don't know if this actually is needed. Configuring console, you will see what this does later. Changes to colors. Extract the game. Run a registry file to mark the game as installed, so the launcher sees the game as installed. Some more INE patches for enabled threaded AI. More threads for everything because the game is not really optimized for modern systems, so you have to tweak stuff. Tweak a few things. I also increased the field of view because it's nice to see more of the world when you walk around. Some audio fixes. So disabling mouse acceleration in the menu because that's really annoying and in game. And then afterwards, when it has. That's the last file now. So it will patch the .exe file with large address aware support, which lets you use HD texture packs and stuff. And then it will run BOSS to sort mods. Right now there's only one mod, it's the unofficial patch. But if in case you had more mods when you install this, it will sort them. I know BOSS is outdated. You can install loot if you want, but it works from command line, so I just threw it in there. And then it enables virtual desktop, and then runs some scripts to manage the save location, so you get the saves in your home folder if you want, and use some nice shortcuts from the game directory to the configs and the data directory. And then it launches the it starts the launcher, so you can configure video settings, so it creates the initial Fallout INE file, and then it ends the install. So it uses staging 3.10 32-bit Wine. This is the latest staging version as of today. It sets a virtual desktop in 720p. You can increase this later to native resolution to get full screen before launching, but you don't really need to because when you start a game in native res in full screen, it fills the screen anyway. You will see. It disables YNG streamer. Game over renderer is not really needed here because this is not a Steam. But in case you use Steam anyway, you won't get the Steam overlay. And some Nvidia and Mesa threading and shader cache variables. I don't know if they really are needed. I haven't tried without them. I just like to throw them in there. It works fine on Mesa and Nvidia, so. And it's almost it's done. So installing game data, patching the exe, extracting the mod pack. And yeah, the mods used, I think you can see them here. It's FOSE, unofficial Fallout 3 patch. Okay. So it's NVAC and stuff. Oh, here we go. So you see, it's a nice desktop background. It will always detect it as high quality because I have set a specific Nvidia GPU. This is to make it work on Intel hardware. Otherwise, it will just crash when you try to run it. So I enable unofficial Fallout 3 patch, important. And then I can choose Ultra and disable screen effects because I don't like Bloom or HDR. And then I choose Full HD, Virtual Sync. Everything is on max. And OK. And play. This is just to create an initial INE file. The game will stop and the installer completes. And then you should be able to see it in Lutris, Fallout 3 Game of the Year edition. And when you launch it, you get this nice little console window with the Fallout 3 colors. So you can start with FOSE, which is the FOSE loader, which starts the game directly. You can start the launcher, which is the Fallout 3 default launcher, to configure video settings. Start directly, it will start the Fallout 3 EXE without FOSE. And then you can auto-sort mods with BOSS, which is already done. I can show you how it looks. It downloads the master list, it does stuff, and it's already run, so it doesn't do anything right now. I want to start with FOSE. As you see, it opens in full screen because I chose full HD. So I already have some saves. I can show you. In my documents folder, my games, Fallout 3. These files are not used anyway. So here are my saves. And the Lutris game folder. You get a config shortcut, which is to easily get to your Fallout INI file and Fallout prefs. So you can change settings if you want, and a shortcut to saves, which is in my home directory. A shortcut to data, to add mods, and in the drive C, Fallout 3 are the game files. And here's the FOSE plugins, NVAC, Fallout Stutter Remover. You can change some settings with the Fallout Stutter Remover, such as maximum frames per second, if you want. Yeah, other tweaks. But let's load a game. Yes. Here we are outside Vault 101. I've already played some, so the game is running smooth. The radio works.
This is a high priority.
I'm on this quest. Yeah, as you can see, I've done some exploring. Small ranch. Yeah. So, this is Fallout 3. FOSE and the anti-stuttering plugin also makes it, when you exit the game, it exits immediately, which is really nice. You can also configure here to set it to your native resolution, which is here for some reason. So when you start it, you see this terminal window. You can choose to start a launcher. You can start it directly or just press enter to start FOSE. Yeah, I've been playing for a few hours without a single crash, so it's pretty stable. The GOG version at least, the Steam version I had some more crashes on. So definitely get this game on GOG. Yeah. Thanks for watching. And I'm out.